Hello, Star Wars fans. This is Typical Russian Guy, your comrade that brings you facts and theories from the Star Wars universe. English subtitles are included, as always. This is the summary of the book Heir to the Empire by Timothy Zahn. The information is taken from Wikipedia, the free encyclopedia. Read for you by Pavel Larin. Now we are ready to start. Gilad Pelion, captain of the Imperial Star Destroyer Chimera, receives word of a successful information raid on the Obroskai system. A retaliatory strike by an Obroskai task force is easily defeated by Pelion's superior, Grand Admiral Thrawn. On Coruscant, Obi-Wan Kenobi approaches Luke Skywalker in his sleep to say farewell, sending Luke into depression. Leia Organa Solo, 3 months pregnant with twins, senses Luke's depression and sends C-3PO to speak with him. On Tatooine, Han Solo and Chewbacca offer legal work to Drevis and his smuggler allies in an attempt to solve the New Republic's shortage on cargo ships, despite the objection of Bothan Councillor Borsk Felia. On Mirkur, a smuggler Talon Cardi and his subordinate Mara Jade help Thrawn and Pelion obtain several creatures called Ysala Miri. Afterward, the Chimera travels to the Emperor's storehouse on Vaylant. On the planet, Thrawn and Pelion encounter Jeruz Kaboth. His name may also be pronounced as Sabaoth, the guardian of the storehouse. Thrawn's Ysala Miri prevents Sabaoth from using the Force within a short radius. With little choice, Sabaoth offers his services in exchange for 2 prospective students, Luke and Leia. Thrawn sends a group of Nogri to capture Luke and Leia on Bimisari, but the attempt fails. Thrawn convinces Sabaoth to seek Luke while the Empire focuses on capturing Leia. Han decides to suspend negotiations with the Bimisari leaders and return to Coruscant. Admiral Akbar, commander-in-chief of the New Republic fleet, agrees with Han's decision, while Felia feels that the departure will generate negative attention. Meanwhile, Thrawn launches his first offensive, a series of hit-and-run attacks into New Republic territory. After another failed kidnapping on Bafarsh, Han and Leia keep a low profile. They decide to visit Lando Calrissian on Niclon. Nogri aliens once again attempt to capture Leia. On Dagobah, Luke discovers a metal cylinder and decides to bring it to Lando for investigation. When the protagonists meet on Niclon to visit Lando, 51 of his Maul miners are stolen by the Empire. Han and Lando discuss plans to visit Talon Cardi as part of the smuggler recruitment operation. The Chimera intercepts a message coming from the Millennium Falcon in Leia's voice, but Thrawn knows it is merely a recording. Through logical reasoning, he determines that Han and Lando are the only ones aboard, and adjusts his plans accordingly. Thrawn nearly captures Luke in a space ambush. Luke escapes, but becomes stranded in his X-Wing fighter with R2-D2 until the Wild Carder discovers them. Luke guesses that the Wild Carder is either a smuggler, a pirate, or a disguised warship. Still, he takes his chances and goes aboard, as he has no other option. Luke wakes up and realizes that he is no longer on a freighter. When he finally wakes up, he notices Mara in the room with him. Cardi is undecided as to what he wants to do with Luke. Han uses C-3PO to transmit a message to Coruscant in Leia's voice. Han interprets their response to mean that Felia is gathering forces to possibly push Akbar out of the New Republic Council. In the meantime, Han and Lando leave the Falcon to meet with a fellow smuggler who is supposed to tell them the location of Talon Cardi's base. Cardi alerts Mara to Han and Lando's arrival and has Luke brought to a secure area before the two arrive. Cardi meets the visitors and is intrigued by the New Republic's offer. When Thrawn hails Carter, he says he needs more Ysel Amiri and wants to have a talk. He tells Carter that he is in a market for some new warships. Thrawn insists on sending stormtroopers to aid in a search and rescue mission. Carter discovers that Han and Lando know about the Imperial's visit. They sneak out to the storage sheds to snoop on the prisoner that Carter is reportedly holding. When they get to the storage room Luke was in, they notice that the door opener was tampered with. Unknown to them, however, Luke and R2 have escaped with Mara chasing them. Mara, Luke, and R2 fight off predators in the forest and camp for the night. Posing as Jade, Luke surrenders Mara and R2 the next day to an Imperial patrol that brings them all to the Mirker spaceport. There, Han, Lando, and Carter's men ambush the Imperial soldiers and rescue Luke and R2 before leaving the planet. With the strain of the recent Nogri kidnapping attempts, Leia and Chewie flee to his homeworld of Kashyyyk. However, another Nogri attacks Leia in the middle of the night. She successfully defends herself, but the alien stops his attack. Chewbacca and Ral Rashin burst into the room immediately, and Leia tells them not to kill the alien. Using her lightsaber, she disables their ship, so they are forced to leave. On board the Chimera, Pelion confirms that there are 112 transient warships available at the Sluis Van shipyards. They activate a cloaking shield and head towards Sluis Van for their attack. Thrawn plans to send stormtroopers to hijack the ships using the stolen Maul miners from Nikolon. Veg and Tillis, who had just arrived at Sluis Van together with the Rogue Squadron, notices a bulk freighter without escort and launches his fighters to inspect it. The Rogues are stunned to see the ship explode and see swarms of TIE fighters strike from the wreckage. The Falcon arrives in the middle of the battle, and Han notices several Imperial Star Destroyers in the area. Remembering how the Empire stole the Maul miners, Lando activates them all by remote control. His move results in many captured warships disabled. Believing that the sudden outcome is simply a temporary setback, Thrawn withdraws the Empire's forces. As Han and Luke rest after the battle, Leia calls from Coruscant to tell them that Admiral Akbar has been arrested on charges of treason. To be continued. So that's it. Please leave your thoughts in the comment section below. I really want to know your opinion. And don't forget to subscribe to this YouTube channel and follow me on Twitter and Reddit if you want to see more videos of this kind. Also, leave a like to help my channel develop, please. Also, if you speak Russian, then visit my YouTube channel called Pavel Larin, on which I'll soon upload a Russian translation of my video. Well, probably not of this particular one. But anyways, thanks for watching, guys. Goodbye.